right? So there are situations when you have a worksheet which is password protected and you forgot the password, or you have a Excel file where one worksheet or multiple worksheets are password protected and you don't know the password. Now in that case, there's an easy way to break that password and use that particular worksheet for editing. So in this video, we're going to learn that method really quickly. So make sure to watch this video till the end. And now let's get started. All right, so I'll start off with the file that I have on my desktop. The first thing that you need to do is you need to create a copy of this file. So this is the original file. And in this file, let me show you, I have some data and the sheet that I have is protected and I don't know the password of this sheet. So as I said, first of all, I'll create a backup copy of this, you know, original file, or I will just use the backup copy instead of the original file. So I'll copy this and I'll paste. So I have this, you know, a duplicate copy of this workbook. And now the next thing that I need to do is I need to rename this file, but I don't need to rename the actual name, but I need to change the extension of this file. So from XLSX, I will go with zip. And the moment I hit enter, it will convert this Excel file into a zip folder. So this will help me to access the data that I have within the Excel file. Now, when I click on it, it opens the zip folder. And now I'm going to go to the folder XL, and then I need to click on worksheets. Now I have this sheet1.xml file, and in this particular XML file, I need to make some changes to change the worksheet from protected to unprotected. So what I'll do, I'll take this file outside and then I'm going to open this in Notepad. Now you can see this file have a lot of data which is in XML format. Now what I'll do, I'll open the find, and here I need to find for a particular word that is called sheet protection. So you need to enter sheet and protection without a space, and the moment you hit enter, it will take you to a XML tag that you have at the very bottom of this, you know, this XML file. Now this tag is little long and you need to select the entire tag. You can see this is the starting of this tag and this is the ending of this tag. So once you select it entirely, you just need to delete it and then press Ctrl S to save the file. And now I'm gonna close this file, the file that I have outside the folder. And now by dragging and dropping, I'm gonna replace this file from the file which I already have in the zip folder. So let me click on copy and replace. And let me close this zip folder and let me delete this file. And now the next thing, I need to convert this file back to an Excel file. So I'll change the extension here. And now I'm like, okay. And all right. So now I have got the Excel file back. Now let me open the file and see if the password is there or not. And let me right click. All right. So you can see the password is broken. We don't have this worksheet protected. So this is the easiest way to break a password from a worksheet where you don't know the password or you just forgot the password. Now, apart from this simple method, there's one more way to unlock a worksheet without a password, and that is by using a VBA code. But I'll tell you very honestly, I don't recommend anyone to use a VBA code. The reason for this is, okay, so let me show you my Visual Basic Editor where I have this code. Now, the problem with this code is it will take a lot of time to break your password or remove your password from a worksheet using the VBA code, because longer the password, longer it will take this code to remove the password. So I will not recommend you to use this code, because you'll find this code, this VBA code, particular VBA code on internet all the times, but I will not recommend you to use this code to break the password.